Hey, everybody, it's Alan, hoping that you all have been well. Today is November 12th, and on this date, back in 2008, we lost the great, great, great drummer, Mr. Mitch Mitchell. Best known for playing with Jimi Hendrix, I think that his phenomenal talent kind of gets overlooked and less discussed than so many other great drummers over the course of the past 50 years because he played with Jimi Hendrix. Jimi Hendrix's star was shining so bright for that brief window of time that he was with us in the main limelight that that anybody who played around him was going to sort of be, I don't know, just kind of overlooked, mostly because Hendrix was just so immensely earth-shatteringly great. And so, anyway, on the anniversary of Mitch Mitchell's passing, we're going to make an attempt at playing you the song 1983, A Merman I Should Turn to Be. It's a longer song off of the Electric Ladyland album. It's actually one of my top three songs off of the Electric Ladyland for my personal love for that album. And I hope this doesn't get blocked. So let's check it out. It's 1983, A Merman I Should Turn to Be.
To take a last walk through the noise to the sea, not to die but to be reborn, away from a land so battered and torn. Such a mess. Every inch of her is a fighting mess. Giant pencil and lipstick tube shaped flames continue to rain and cause screaming pain and the arctic stains from silver blue to bloody red as our feet find the sand and the sea is straight ahead. That's what they say. That's why they coming with this thing. And they also said it's impossible for a man to live and breathe underwater. Forever was a main complaint. And they also threw this in my face. They said, anyway, you know good and well, it would be beyond the will of God and the grace of the king. So my darling and I make love in the sand.
to salute the last moment ever undressed. A machine has done its work, played its part well, without a scratch on a body, and we bid it farewell. Starfish and giant fumes greet us with a smile. Before our heads go under, we take a last look at the killing noise.
Warp the outer style. The outer style, outer style.
Thank you. champion games to an aqua world is so very dear. Right this way smiles a mermaid. I can hear a chorus full of cheer.
Take a minute to think about this. When they were recording that in the studio, they were pretty much probably jamming out the 13-minute track that you just heard. Most likely it was just the three of them in the studio actually laying that down. And they weren't having the sound effects panned back and forth. They weren't having all this other stuff. It was really just a dry live performance. And they were just jamming it out. Imagine how much different that sounded afterward, or during, I should say. How different it sounded than what we're used to listening to on the album after Eddie Kramer worked his studio magic on it. You know, I mean, it must have been one hell of a jam session, and I kind of would love to hear the tracks dry without all the panning, phasing, and overdumbing. You know, there's those instances where in this particular mix, Eddie Kramer is pulling up and pulling back certain instruments. You know, there's the point where the bass comes way, way, way to the forefront in the last 5 minutes of the song. And the drums and the guitar just get pushed way to the back and way off to the sides. And the bass line's right there in the middle. I'm just saying it must have been a really interesting situation hearing it live in the studio as they were laying down the bass tracks before all the overdubs, before the adding in of the chimes, before all the extra feedback guitar solo stuff was laid in there, before again Eddie Kramer started panning the signal from left to right, left to right, left to right. It must sound completely different. And yet through it all, Mitch Mitchell is holding that backbeat rhythm down perfectly. You know, you listen to that center section and it's very freeform. It's very freeform. But in its freeform and chaos, there's still a consistent thing, which is Mitch Mitchell's drumming beating along right in the background, whether it be him riding on the ride cymbal or the hi-hat, or him, you know, sort of subtly tapping the bass drum just to kind of keep a, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4 sort of timing situation happening there. So they knew when they came back into it at the end of it that they weren't going to be vastly different than the original tempo. I'm just saying it must have been one hell of an interesting recording process. God, I hope this doesn't get blocked. You know, the Hendrix people are notorious for blocking content, and obviously I'm doing a much longer song than, you know, Hey Joe or Fire or, you know, whatever, Purple Haze. But again, this is to highlight, you know, Mitch Mitchell's birthday, or sorry, the anniversary of Mitch Mitchell's passing. Excuse me, it's not his birthday. I just hope it doesn't get blocked. Well, if you do end up seeing it, please feel free to leave a comment in the comment section below. We can talk about it further. Just know that I appreciate all of you, and I wish you well. Take care.